School. We have some pretty talented students doing some amazing things.
Don't forget the teachers too!
Yeah, sure. Teachers are pretty cool too.
So what's up first?
Where should we start?
How about some mad science?
Great idea.
Let's go.
Welcome to
Puff
and Puffs
Mad Science.
Hello and welcome to the Puff and Puff
Sizzling Science Madness.
Today we're producing Slippity Sloppity Slime with our one and only magnificent Einstein-y.
Ooh, slime! What happens if it gets in my hair?
Today we will be using borax, which you can buy from Bunnings. Borax is a naturally occurring mineral that is sometimes used for cleaning. Like every science experiment, have an adult help you and let them handle the borax.
Now, let's take a look at the ingredients we're going to use for this fascinating slime experiment.
1 teaspoon of borax, 1.5 cups of water, a plastic bowl, 1/2 cup of glue, some glitter and food colouring.
Here are the step-by-step instructions of how to make slime.
Stir your borax into 1 cup of water. Stir until the borax is dissolved, then put it aside for now.
In another plastic bowl, put in 1/2 cup of glue.
Add your 1/2 cup of water into the bowl. And stir well.
Now we're going to add 2 drops of food colouring into the mixture. For the next step, put the borax and the water into the mixture, then mix.
Stir your 2 mixtures together until clumps form. Using your hands, take the gooey clumps out of the mixture and place on a plate. Drain off excess water and allow to dry for a few minutes. Smush slime together with your hands till it binds.
Place it on a plate and let it dry for a few minutes. Once it's done, then you can take it off and play with it. Such gooey-tastic fun.
Wow, that was amazing.
Yeah, those scientists really know their stuff.
Remember kids, don't try this at home.
Since this is a new year, we have a new piece for you.
What is it again?
It's Brain Busters, Jesus.
Sorry, my memory is not great.
Just roll the tape.
I've got a perfect puzzle for you.
Hi, I'm Jamie.
And I'm Ruby.
And welcome to Where in the World?
Look out for clues throughout the TV show and see where we are in the world.
Submit your guesses to Team Carreria, which you can find via the Silverdale School website.
Oh my gosh, I had the weirdest meal last night, but it's so delicious.
Yeah, I'm going to a restaurant tonight, and it includes frogs and snails.
Trust me, you'll like it. It's delicious.
That's great. Now let's go take a bus to our next destination.
This teacher teaches in the Pukeko team.
The
the Brain Busters crew have made it very hard for us this term to figure out who it is. Anyway,
Amy and Anya have been going around the school looking at you amazing kids.
Let's go see what the news crew have created for us.
Welcome to the first edition of Silverdale School News this year. There have been a lot of interesting activities happening around the school so far.
First, why don't we go check out the new build?
Hi guys, we're here at the new school build. You might have been wondering why we are building new classrooms and who are going in it.
I've heard there are 8 new classrooms going in because Silverdale School is growing so much. In 2006, there were 145 students. Now there's 550. We have also interviewed Mr. Lockie to find out what the next step is for the new building.
How do you feel about the new build?
Very excited. Excited for the Team Pukeko, so that they can come out in their temporary classrooms and be able to go into the new 8 classrooms there. And also for our new entrant class, 5A, we're going to go from where they are into the new building as well. So excited, but also frustrated. It's taken so long to rebuild. And I've only just been here for 8 minutes. Okay, the next step for our building project will build another 8 classrooms along the same line across there. So we're hoping for that to start sometime this year and for those classrooms to be open up sometime next year as well. So again, the build will be the same sort of classrooms, 2 classrooms and then the fitting space, and there'll be another 8 classrooms as well.
What do you think is going to happen to Silverdale School in the future?
Well, at the moment we're experiencing quite a heavy roll growth. At the moment we've got 555 students on the roll. So, and we're growing. We're pretty much growing every day. Next term we've got 24 new entrants starting, and then term after that, in term 4, we've got about 15 starting. So we're going to finish the year around about 600. As well. So that's going to be becoming a large primary school for all.
Thank you for your time, and we hope that everyone enjoys the new build.
You're welcome, and I'm sure they will. I'm sure the teachers are looking forward to it, and also the kids are looking forward to it as well.
Thanks for watching. Bye.
Wow, that looks fantastic. Can't wait to move in.
Now why don't we see what Team Pukeko is doing?
I heard they had a sleepover in the hall.
That sounds like so much fun. Let's go and have a look.
The 3 and 4 pooks asking them about the sleepover.
What was the best thing about your sleepover?
Having the teachers with the water guns.
That aqua run.
Soaking the teachers with our water guns.
What did you learn from the sleepover?
I learned how to build an arcade box.
How to dive.
Roll my sleeping bag up by myself.
How to do my sleeping bag.
To have been there with them.
Yeah, it was probably as cool as camping.
Speaking of camping, the year 5 and 6s went out to Shakespeare Camping Ground. Let's check it out.
Let's talk to some years from 5 and 6s to see what their amazing camp was like.
What was your favourite thing at camp?
My favourite thing at camp was sailing.
My favourite thing at camp was sailing.
Did you learn at camp?
I learned how to tie different knots.
At camp I learned how to sail.
And what you expected?
No, I didn't think camp was what I expected because
I thought the activities were going to be really different.
No, camp was not what I expected. I expected we'd be sitting around a fire in the middle of the night, eating marshmallows.
We're back again?
Go to camp again because it was so fun.
Yes, I would like to go back again to camp because it was so exciting.
What could you have done better?
I think that I can work as a team better because in rock building we didn't really work as a team.
Could have been a better team member.
I wish I had gone to the camp. It looks like a lot of fun.
I agree. Why don't we go see what the intermediates have been up to? I heard it was a lot of fun.
What was it? Snowboarding, snow planets, skiing, surfing. Aren't they lucky?
Let's go have a look at these short clips.
Hi, I'm Isabel.
And I'm Amber.
And I'm Tony. And we're here with Team Career at Snow Planet.
This is Snow Planet.
Let's see what Team Career has been up to.
Winter time has come. Let's go and have some fun. In the snow we can play. The whole frosty day. In the snow we can play. We can ski. We can play with snowballs. In the snow we can skate. We can run. We can ride a snowboard. Winter time has come. We are ready for some fun.
Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me. Come on a safari with me.
What did you enjoy most about surfing?
I think the things I enjoyed most was learning new skills and keeping my balance on the surfboard.
What was the highlight of your day?
The highlight of my day was actually getting to surf and learning new techniques.
What skills did you learn during the surfing lessons?
Well, I learned how to stand up on a surfboard and keep my balance.
Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me.
That looked cool. The school has now introduced a new program called electives.
Every student in the school got to pick from a range of activities.
Let's see what they got up to.
Over the past few terms, Silverdale School students have had the opportunity to learn what they want by choosing different elective groups.
How do you think the bushes help the students?
I think the enviro activity has helped the students to understand how important the enviro is. You'll never know quite when. Well, then again, it just depends on how long your time is left. You, I've had the highest mountains, I've had the deepest rhythm. You can have it all, but now keep moving. I'll take it in.
About dance and drama.
I like dance and drama because you get to make scripts with your friends and get to act it out, and it's really fun.
The reason why I like dance and drama is because you can express yourself in your own way.
Last up today, we will look at how Silverdale School remembers the 100th year anniversary of Anzac Day.
The opening ceremony for our commemorative garden was in the Silverdale School Hall on the 20th of April 2015. This day was to remember the ones that risked their lives for New Zealand. A special man called Max from the RSA talked to us about the First World War.
On the 1st of May 2015, Silverdale School had a closing ceremony for our commemorative garden.
Silverdale School gathered around the flagpole to think of the soldiers that fought in World War I. As the last post was played, we all came to a silence. Some of the student council members took the crosses down and gradually the flag moved down the pole.
Silverdale started to sing the Silverdale song as the flag moved back up. It was a special day for Silverdale because we got to remember what the Anzacs did for us.
Thanks for watching another episode of Silverdale News.
Bye!
We've been very busy this year so far.
So what's up next?
It's Brainbusters!
I've got a perfect puzzle for you.
Oh my god, look at this!
Do you know this is one of the most famous structures in the world? It was also built in 1889 for a grand entrance for a fair.
You learn something new every day.
This teacher is new to our school.
So, what do you think the answer is?
It seems pretty hard!
I think I know the answer, but I don't want to spoil it!
I wonder what the next segment is.
It's over our sports, don't you remember?
Let's go check it out.
We have competed in lots of zone days such as soccer, rugby and ultimate frisbee.
Thursday the 5th of May, over 100 football enthusiasts from Silverdale, Wainui, Wentworth and Gulf Harbour School were met by a sunny day at Sinclair Park.
The day was organised by the Northern Football Federation and all the schools that were there were supporting the Women's World Cup in Canada or the Under-20 Men's World Cup here in New Zealand. All the teams supported a country or a football firm by dressing up, making banners and singing chants. The games were played in a 5v5 format and were self-ref by the players, which meant that honesty and fairness was the order of the day. With 8 games each and only one small break, the final whistle was a welcome sound. Everyone tried their best and it sure was an awesome day. 5 and 6 soccer on, Team Tui took 2 match-ready soccer teams to play soccer. The year 5 and 6 did so well that they came 3rd place in the whole competition. Everyone who went to play showed good sportsmanship and teamwork.
Okay. During these past 2 terms, the Year 7s and 8s have participated in 2 Ripper and Tackle tournaments.
During the first tournament, the Ripper girls won one of their games. They also got a training session with a Black Ferns player. She taught them some cool tips and helped them in their games. The boys' tackle team unfortunately weren't as successful, not winning any games, but they drew 2. In the second tournament, the boys' tackle team did much better, winning 1 game and the girls' Ripper winning 2.
In June, the juniors had a hard-fought cross-country.
They ran under tarpaulins, over hurdles, through the mud and over hay bales. Congrats to Maya, Max, Michaela, Jack, Jamie, Billy, Sophie, Christopher for coming first. And in second place, we had Taylor, Millen, Hamish, Ruby, Timmy, Lola and Becca.
Silverdale School sent 3 Year 7 and 8 and 2 Year 5 and 6 teams to an Ultimate Frisbee Zone Day.
This day was held at Silverdale Rugby Club and was run by our very own Mr. Riley. Schools from Gulf Harbour, Derry Flat, Kingsway, Wainui and of course us, we battled it out to see who was the Ultimate Frisbee champ. In the end we came 2nd in Year 7 and 8 and the Year 5 and 6 competitions.
Lucas.
And Maddie.
And today we are interviewing Dean Cousins.
How old were you when you first started competing competitively?
For the New Zealand team, I was about 19 years old, I think I was. So I just started at university. It was a pretty exciting time for me. It was very enjoyable.
What got you into hockey? Did you play it a lot when you were young?
Yeah. I got into hockey because my brother was playing hockey, so he's my older brother. He's 3 years older than me, so I would go along to his games. I think it's quite common in families. You go and watch your big brother play, and someone doesn't turn up because they're sick. So I started playing and filling in, and then I really enjoyed it. And then a lot of my friends from primary school started to play, you know, in the same teams as me. So that was great. And did I play a lot when I was young? Yes. We played it at school, played it at home in the lounge, much to my mum's annoyance with little hockey sticks. We didn't break too many things, but there was the odd casualty.
What's your favourite memory playing hockey?
It's a tough question because there's a lot of really good memories. I think my favourite memories are probably Olympic Games. So I was really lucky that I got to go to three Olympic Games. So I went in 2004 to Athens and Beijing in China. There's an 8 and then to London. So that's pretty my favourite things. But also alongside that is the really good friends that I made and the travel that I got to do. So lots of really good ones, but yeah, without doubt the Olympics was something really special.
Yeah, for young kids who want to start playing hockey.
Again, that's another good question. I think that probably like most people would say, practice is really important. So yeah, I think getting out there onto the turf or in and around home and you know, just having the ball and end of your stick, so you know, you have that good control is important. And there's no doubt that the kind of the basics, the building blocks for whatever sport you play, whether it's rugby, soccer, hockey, you know, the basics of the game are really important. So the sooner you can kind of really develop those to a high level, the better. So I think practice your basics would be my best piece of advice, and have fun. Enjoy.
Thank you.
We have an exciting new segment for you.
Called Silverdale Snaps. Let's go check it out.
Freeze frame!
Kawaii to Ingua. Kawaii
to Ingua. Kawaii to Ingua. Kawaii to Ingua.
Kawaii to Ingua.
Kawaii
to Ingua.
Kawaii
to Ingua. Kawaii
to Ingua. Kawaii
to Ingua. Kawaii to Ingua. Kawaii to Ingua.
Learn a language! Khaki
well,
together.
I think I'm gonna have to work on that.
That sounds pretty hard.
Yep, it sure does.
So, Ryan, what's up next?
I can't remember. Do you know Taylor?
Yes, it's Brain Busters!
Oompa dee doo, I've got a perfect puzzle for you. Oompa, oompa, doompa dee dee.
What's this dance called again?
It's the Can Can. It's a traditional dance for this country, you know.
I'm going to try this when I get home.
No. Anyway, we better be getting back. We've got somewhere to be.
This teacher has two sons at this school.
If you guess Mrs. Nickname, then you are correct.
I knew it! Whatever.
Come on, guys, let's stay on task. Let's go straight to Good Sort.
This term's Good Sort is Poppy Pierce from Room 12. In week one of this term, Poppy organized and ran an Anzac assembly commemorating our Anzac soldiers that went to Gallipoli.
Poppy's qualities are time management skills, organizational skills, and she can handle a lot of responsibility.
This year was a special year for Anzac Day as it was the 100th year since the Anzacs landed on Anzac Cove in Gallipoli. During the holidays, Poppy took time out of her holiday to create the assembly and make sure that it was a success. Overall, the assembly turned out great and all of the teachers are grateful for what she has achieved.
Poppy, why did you choose to organise the Anzac Assembly?
Anzac Assembly, because it was a great opportunity to learn about Anzac Day and it would bring up my public speaking skills.
Yeah, I would like to achieve getting on the honours board because it has been a dream of mine and I think I have the right qualities.
Tune in next time for next term's Good Sort.
If you guys enjoyed this term's episode of What's Up Silverdale, tune in next term for another episode of What's Up Silverdale. See ya!
Bye!